Des, King of the Pit TV, signing in. A little bit bunged up today, but don't you mind me. You might catch a little yawn from me as well, to be honest. It is the weekend, bros. I don't want to do ambient mode. This one's entitled Bike Scene, track 2 of 10. I don't know what to expect with this band. It's incredible production. The frontman has an incredible voice. Let's go. And are many bands doing this sound nowadays? Cause this still sounds so fresh, man. I wanna hate you so bad, but I can't stop this any more than you can. There is a tension within the music. It feels like they don't go as far as climaxing. We might get like a full-on beat and like explosion of rhythm by the end, potentially. But I was going to comment on the first one. It feels like we're building up to something, but we never really get there. You know, the drum beats in particular, it feels like we want to explode and then, you know what I mean? Start driving that that head bopper. But we continue just building it up and staying in this, I would consider, awkward space in between. Which is what's created the sound, the soundscape of the act, which isn't a bad sound whatsoever. I think this record so far has sounded absolutely incredible, but there is an awkward underlying tension to the music, I think. But I think that also adds to the emotional value, because it does create this, I don't know, this incongruency with what we expect from brilliant bands. It's not as direct. I know so many girls were singing this section back in the bedrooms, back in the day. My Chemical Romance poster on the wall. What magazines were we buying back then? Kerrang magazine. This wasn't one for the Metal Hammer crowd, was it? Welcome to the Black Parade centerfold on the wall. And then we might have a Panic at the Disco. Fella wearing top hat, whoever fronted that band with his band behind him on the wall. Who else have we got? Paramore. Definitely throw a little Paramore poster up there as well. going. Where we going? You've got me right. Them dual vocals are incredible. This is the moment I was waiting for. I've waited two tunes for it to escalate to this. This was the beat I was looking for. That was brilliant. Yeah, that was really good. There's definitely going to be a consistency in this record. You can just tell that they are a brilliant band from the get-go. I mean, this isn't necessarily anything I would choose to listen to, but just with it being one of them bands from back in the day that I never checked out, I felt it was worthwhile doing so. Alongside towards, you know, remain within the alternate band environment for this channel, but sort of give a little bit back to the softer side of things. This one's entitled Cute Without the E. I've listened to this one before.